What's up, everybody? Welcome to another episode of $20 Chef. It's the Super Bowl episode. What could I possibly do to make this the most Super Bowl episode ever? Have the greatest kicker in Super Bowl history on, Mr. Adam Vinatieri. I appreciate you.
Thanks for having me.
For letting me kidnap your whole day, come out here. You know, you're a big game guy. You love hunting. So we went and got some bison steaks, some bison ribeye, which I was excited about, never had them. So I figured, you know, we're gonna go meat and potatoes today. So we're just, I saw this dude on the internet. He did it like this on the grill. So we're just gonna cut it like, almost like potato steaks. And then some cabbage. I saw this recipe where you just cut that all up, put it in foil with some onion and butter and a little salt and pepper. This combination mixed up with the bison, I think it's gonna be doing nice.
Yeah, that's gonna be great.
So you can go ahead and start with these. I'll hit that and I'll hit this cabbage over here. So you're the grill man around here from what I understand.
This is usually when it's snowing like this is usually when my wife hands me some steaks and says, get out there and start grilling.
Yeah, yeah. But
you and my wife, get me out there freezing my butt off out there, you know?
That was a real close kickoff I just had with your son there. I don't know if you, AJ Vinatieri, sophomore in high school, we'd have a little punt off in the snow. A lot of people said that during the street football days, I was one of the better punters on my street. So, I mean, you're in for some trouble. Adam, I apologize if I hit the house and there's a problem with the neighbors. You know, you signed up for it when you said we could do this episode. Beat that. I don't even know why he's kicking. He don't have a shot here. Yikes. All right, let's go cut up the cabbage.
That was impressive, yeah.
I mean, if you want to drop my name to the league or anything like that, because it was my impressive talents.
Yeah, there's probably something in out there that you fill water bottles and stuff like
that. I can fill water bottles. And I'm really good at catching all the balls, too. Well, they'll bounce off my chest and I'll have red marks for a while.
You get balls on your chest a lot?
You know, hey, it happens. Sometimes you take a ball to the chest, you get red marks, you just got to deal with it. There's nothing you can do about it. You know, since it's obviously Super Bowl week, you got these two teams doing their thing all week long, gearing up for this big-ass game. A lot of people say that your 48-yarder in the snow was the greatest kick in NFL history. You happen to also have several other amazing kicks in the Super Bowl for game winners. If someone was like, tell me what the best kick was in your life right now, or I'm going to take away your ranch, or some shit like that, what would you say?
I suppose probably the one in the snow was definitely the most difficult one, and being the fact that we were down by 3 points, if I miss it, our season's over and we're cleaning out our locker that next day. So I would say that's probably the one that I'm the most proud of, because it was probably the most difficult kick that I've ever had to make, but there's been a couple good ones along the way, for sure.
How long does it take to come down from a high of that?
You get to do a lot of cool things after that. You get to go to Disney World, you're on some of the TV shows.
Oh, so you actually go to Disney World? I thought it was just to get damn commercials.
No. If you win it, they invite you and you get to go. So I even got to kick footballs to President Trump now, but he was just he wasn't the president back when I got to kick balls to him on the David Letterman show. So you get to do a lot of cool things like that. Ironically enough, could you imagine if I'd hit a ball and it ended up hitting him or hitting him in the face or something like that? Would have been a bad deal. So
thank goodness
it didn't happen.
All right, well, here we got our cabbage here. We're gonna foil this up. You can put the potatoes in there.
You bet.
Are you superstitious at all?
I'm not real superstitious, to be honest with you. I do have a pretty extensive preparation getting ready for the game, but I just lucky socks or lucky jock or something like that. No, I really don't. I've got a pretty substantial ritual that I do pre-game, middle of game, that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
But I don't really think it's superstition. It's just more preparation.
All right, you can hit this with some salt and pepper here. Nice and simple. I mean, it's literally potatoes, some cabbage, and some sweet-ass bison ribeye, and we're rocking and rolling. All right, we'll just throw this butter in there. My foil job here, I loaded it up too much. At a shitty Mexican restaurant, they do this with burritos.
Now, we were told nothing more than rare, so especially with wild game, with venison, with elk, with some of that stuff, keeping it at that medium rare kind of stuff is really the rarer the better, I guess, is to your liking, right?
Yeah, and these are looking really nice. You want to start to throw some salt and pepper on there? There it is. And then we can just take the salt and pepper out there, so we have to flip them over now. When we flip them, we'll season them out there.
I like it.
What kind of wood we got here?
I think we got some hickory.
A little hickory?
Yeah.
Well, we're 2 days away from Super Bowl. What is it about being so clutch that you just excel? I would shit my pants.
You know, the week leading up to it's a fiasco. It's true. You're trying to get tickets to your family.
Yeah.
You're trying to figure out how many hotel rooms you have and who's staying where. But for me, in all the times that I've been fortunate to play in 5 Super Bowls, and each one of those, you just kind of focus in on your job. You know, put all the noise around you out of your mind and just really concentrate on, for me, kicking the ball. And I knew my guys up front were going to do a good job snapping and blocking, and my holder was going to do a good job. So if you can just focus in on what you have to do and not think about all the extra extracurricular stuff, you're better off.
Yeah, we were also talking about, you know, it's tough because you have record-breaking ranch. That's a ranch in Missouri where, you know, hunters go, and you guys have, you know, an amazing situation there with all the deer and the hunting and the facility and everything. But it is making it tough because you say that the best time to go there is when the season's on.
There's a few things in life that I want to do once football's done and over with, but that's one of my big passions, just a sunrise or a sunset that you don't get to experience when you're in the city. So I want you guys to come out too, check it out. Maybe we can do a 2.0, you know, the $20 Chef 2.0 out there. But you're right, it's one of those things that I don't get to do a lot of hunting during the season, obviously, but I get out as much as I can, for sure.
Well, I know that you're right now, you're rehabbing, you just had some surgeries, but your son, he's kicking bombs already. He's a sophomore in high school. I just saw a film of him kicking a 50-yarder.
It's awesome. You know, I've been around some of the best athletes in the world all my career. I really enjoy watching my kids perform too, and I think the expectation is pretty high for them when they go, oh, Vinatieri's kid, okay, you know. But I honestly get as much joy watching my kids perform and do their thing as being on the field myself. I'm looking forward to seeing your skills too. Yeah. It'll be good.
All right, let's go see what I got here. Okay, so I think we should just throw the cabbage here on the side. Let's just let it start doing its thing down here.
I like it. Potatoes are gonna go right on the grill?
Yeah, I think so. Let's go with this meat out here.
I think we'll put the potatoes closer into the flame and the meat a little bit off because he doesn't want direct heat, right?
Yeah, some of it, he said it could be good without that direct heat.
These potatoes are fairly thick, so they're gonna have to be in more of a
flame. That fire. We got good grill marks on them potatoes.
I like a wood or even a charcoal fire much more than just propane. It just gives it so much a better flavor and better taste and all that stuff. So.
Yeah, just the smell. The entire experience is so much better with charcoal and just wood fire.
Yep.
Well, we got to turn these over. This fire's going quick here. It's at pretty high temp.
Who wanted that extra piece of wood on there?
Who did it? That was me. I fucked it up.
Well, just make sure those bison's doing all right.
Looking good. So these were still super rare. But we're looking to get a good sear here out the gate. You always want to have a nice sear on the outside of your steaks. This guy's ready to flip. I'm going to move him to the outside. But with the indirect heat on the steaks now, it's going really nice.
Yeah, the steaks look awesome.
It must feel good to be, there's literally the most athletic humans on the planet play football, and you're the leading scorer of every single one of them of all time.
Yeah, but I'm just a kicker. You know, it's funny though, the misconception was always that specialists weren't real football players and stuff, but I tell you, over the last 20 years, I've met a lot of really, really good athletes that, you know, punters and kickers and specialist long snappers.
Well, yeah, well, early on, I mean, you showed everybody that you weren't a kicker, that you were coming for that ass when you laid out Herschel Walker. I mean, that was...
Yeah, I'm not nearly as fast as he is. I just had 10 seconds of speed. He broke loose and started heading to the end zone, and there was nobody else to catch him except for me, and I guess they were about our 25-yard line or so, and I dove out and wrapped him up and brought him to the ground, and he jumped up, threw the ball down, and turned back and looked, and I'm sure to his surprise it was number 4, two different shoes on, like, who the hell is this guy just tackled me? And he probably got beat down by all of the guys on his team for getting caught by the kicker, but I always wanted to send him a picture of me tackling him and just to see if he'd sign it for me. Yeah. Not disrespectful to him, just, hey, this is my best moment ever. Would you sign this for me?
Yeah.
You know? I haven't had the courage to ask him yet.
How are we looking over here?
It looks awesome. Looks really good.
Yeah.
That has to be about good, don't you think?
Yeah, I think so. Cabbage coming out. Look at that butter.
Now the expectation is going to be that. My wife's going to make me cook like this every time.
I just ruined
it. So good. Now you're going to go sit out in the snow next time and cook me some steaks, damn it.
Oh, shit. I think we're getting there.
Mm-hmm. You're better off undercooking than overcooking it,
yeah.
Right?
Should we get them off?
I think they look good.
Yeah, I think so. What do you think is worse, missing a kick to win the Super Bowl?
Yes. Don't even go any further. Nothing else in the world's worse than that.
All right, we're rocking and rolling. Let's get in there and eat this food. I found these in the knife drawer. I'm not sure what these are. Those Super Bowl rings. Why are some bigger than the others?
Well, that would be a losing Super Bowl ring.
Oh, okay.
And that would be a winning Super Bowl ring. So there's 4 good ones and there's 2 quote unquote kissing your sister rings.
This is incredible. Thanks, hey, Desmond Howard, you didn't have to do that, man. You know, he just could have just went with the 1 small one and the 5 big ones. You're a real asshole, Desmond. And I think it's time to eat. Our cabbage, that came out really nice. Got a little onion in there, that you can smell the butter. And then we got our little, my little Pinterest potatoes there. Simple, basic, you know, baked potato topping, sour cream, cheese, a little bit of bacon and some green onion, and boom. There it is, just a little clean, simple, everything done at one time on the grill style plate, except we went big with the bison ribeyes. All right, well, I think it's time to eat, but I'm pretty excited because your wife is best friends with my girlfriend, so I think that makes you and me best friends now.
I know.
Well, maybe. No means maybe. You know how it is. Come on.
Just... Never.
All right, well.